Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, one true God, forever and ever. Amen. Dearly beloved in Christ, our God is a loving God, a forgiving God, a righteous God, and a compassionate God. In tomorrow's Gospel reading, that is St. Matthew chapter 15, verses 32 to 39, we see the compassion of our Lord towards the people with Him for the last 3 days. He said to His disciples, I have compassion for the crowd, because they have been with me now for 3 days and have nothing to eat. And I do not want to send them away hungry, for they might faint on the way. What is compassion? Compassion is love in action. It implies empathy coupled with an urgent desire to help. Throughout the life of Jesus, we see how He offered such compassion. We may empathize or sympathize with people or situations. It ends with an emotion. But compassion goes beyond this emotion and finds solution. A compassionate person does not leave the person or situation behind, but takes initiative to resolve the issue. This is what we see in this gospel passage. People are in hunger. They may faint on their way back to their home. The compassionate Jesus does not want to send them away in this condition. He takes initiative to feed them and satisfy them. Then the miracle happened. We see this incident only as a miracle. It is, of course, a miracle of Jesus. But when we think about this, it really challenges us. What would we do in this situation? In other Gospels, we see the disciples asking Jesus to send the people away because they don't want to take the responsibility. They don't want to take the burden of that people. Don't think that the disciples do not have sympathy or empathy towards these people. I would say they don't have the compassion to take the responsibility and resolve the need of the people. One of the characteristics of a Christian disciple is compassion. Are we compassionate Christians to share the burden of people around us? If we are compassionate, the following elements should be with us always. First, bringing attention or awareness or recognizing that there is suffering. We will automatically know that there is suffering among people. Second, feeling emotionally moved by that suffering. We will be emotionally affected by the suffering of others. Third, wishing that there be relief from the suffering. We intentionally think about the suffering of people. Fourth, a readiness to take action to relieve that suffering. We will be motivated to do something to resolve the suffering. Among the Christians, we see emotional people who sympathize and go. We see intelligent people who always think about their own protection only. But at the same time, we also see compassionate people who even take risk to rescue the people who suffer. I believe that the ministry of the church continues through these compassionate people. There are lots of talks going on about people's suffering and problems. But only the compassionate people walk the talk. At present, we are in the process of forming a COVID-19 response team in each parish and in regional level. We have to take care of ourselves by keeping the rules and regulations given by the state, union governments and health department. But at the same time, we need to take care of the affected people and their family members. It gives a sense of gladness to see many people coming to the forefront to shoulder the responsibility of helping people during this pandemic. But sadly, there are capable people who save themselves by slipping away from such responsibilities. But I pray and hope as we move forward, more and more people would come forward and lend a helping hand. Let us not forget that we are not just called to be inside the church, but to be the church. A walking and living church, bearing the marks of a compassionate God. This gospel passage reminds us that our God is a compassionate God, and we are the beneficiaries of His compassion. But it also challenges us that the disciples of Christ, we show compassion, which is love in action, to the people who suffer. We ought to show compassion of God through our lives. When we die, the question which remains is what our contribution to the church was in particular and to the world at large. May the Holy Spirit inspire us to become compassionate Christians. May God bless all of us.